Joining us now for more, the national president of the Zionist Organization of America, Mort Klein, is with us. Mort, this is a very big award for people here that might not be familiar. Winston Churchill has received this award. Harry Truman got this after the Second World War. Tell us about it.
It is rarely given only to those who are the most extraordinary supporters of the Jewish people and the Jewish state. Golda Meir, David Ben-Gurion, as you mentioned, Truman, Winston Churchill, and Balfour. But Donald Trump has been the greatest president for Israel and for U.S.-Israel relations ever in the White House. So he clearly deserved this award. He moved the embassy to Jerusalem. He said that Jews have every right to live in Judea and Samaria, the West Bank. He has the strongest sanctions on Iran. And he stopped money to the Palestinians. We were giving the Palestinian Arabs $500 million of taxpayers' money, even though the Palestinian Authority pays Arabs to murder Americans and Jews. If you murder an American, you get a lifetime pension. And Trump said, no more money from America as long as you keep paying people to murder Americans and Jews. And I'm sorry to say that Joe Biden not only reinstituted the $500 million, he now gives the Palestinian Authority $800 million, ignoring the fact that they pay Arabs to murder Americans and Jews. And name school streets and sports teams after murderers.
Well, you don't need to apologize. You're just reporting the facts. I thought it was interesting to see Donald Trump wearing a tuxedo twice in the same weekend, both for this event and then his daughter's wedding. Not something you normally see. I don't expect it tomorrow night when he makes this announcement from Mar-a-Lago. Many say that if Donald Trump were a Democratic president, he would have won the Nobel Peace Prize for the Abraham Accords and the work that he and his team, along with Jared Kushner and many others, accomplished in just 4 years' time, by the way. What do you make of that?
It is astonishing that President Obama won the Nobel Peace Prize a month after he's president for nothing. Yasser Arafat, the terrorist, won the Nobel Peace Prize. Here, this man made peace with Bahrain, UAE, Morocco, and Sudan, called the Abraham Accords, peace deals that were never imaginable. And I think it is really an enmity toward Donald Trump or toward his party, because nobody deserved the Peace Prize more than Donald Trump. He still should hopefully be getting it in the future. And he mentioned that if he was still president, he was ready to have many more peace deals with many more countries, that peace would be breaking out all over the Middle East. People are not appreciating how much he did for peace in the Middle East, which affects the United States of America because of the funding of terrorism by Iran, terrorists who attack Americans as well as Jews.
It looks like Benjamin Netanyahu is going to be in charge in Israel once again. His relationship with Joe Biden, not great. He's been pretty vocal about how much he enjoyed working with Donald Trump. Can you talk about that dynamic?
Joe Biden and Netanyahu have been friends for a long, long time. And the problem is Joe Biden has been hostile to Israel. He's promoting establishing a Palestinian terror state, which is a dictatorship, which is a terrorist dictatorship. And as well, he has been criticizing members of the new government that's being formed, Biden has, as well as other members of his party. While he never criticized Ra'am, a Muslim Brotherhood radical terrorist group in the previous government, and never criticized Abbas or Mahmoud Shtaya, who have made horrible statements against America. So there is a problem, and the problem stems from my own government here in America, Joe Biden, who's not looking at these rationally or fairly, and Netanyahu has his hands full to try and deal with that.
Okay. Well, Mort Klein, it looks like it was a great ceremony over the weekend. We appreciate you breaking it down for us this morning. Thank you.
Over 1,000 cheering people with standing ovations a dozen times. It was unbelievable evening.
Nice to hear. You should have been there. I know. I should have been there, Mort. I'm with you. Maybe next time. Okay. Mort Klein, thank you.
Thanks.